Dobry wieczór Państwu.
Good evening.
Mesdames, Messieurs, bonsoir. Bardzo mi przyjemnie powitać Państwa.
I'm very pleased to welcome you here at Galerie Hus. Spelled H-U-S, and I'd like to thank Tristan Mounier. This is a special event for me. This is a stateless territory that we're in. Polish artists have been allowed into a French gallery, and this is being streamed live to the US, so it's truly incredible.
Pour moi parce que c'est un live stream qui va partir vers les États-Unis aussi puisqu'on est filmé par les Américains et je suis ravie d'être ici dans cette galerie en dehors de l'État polonais.
Ponieważ już wasz wielki francuski artysta Alfred Jarry.
Your great French artist, Alfred Jarry, said that things happen in Poland, that is to say, nowhere. The scene is set in Poland, which is to say, nowhere. My name is Joanna Klas, and I represent the Adam Mickiewicz Institute, which is a national institution that's tasked with talking and infecting others with Polish culture.
Talking about Polish culture and infecting others with it. Qui est chargée de diffuser la culture polonaise, de l'infecter entre guillemets, d'infecter la culture polonaise dans d'autres pays.
And your culture here is special, and even for Adam Mickiewicz, Paris was an exceptional, remarkable place in his life. Thank you very much for the welcome in this week when we're holding a retrospective of this great artist.
Un endroit particulièrement important. Et surtout en ce moment, au moment où se déroule la rétrospective d'un grand metteur en scène polonais, Krystian Lupa.
Dla nas to jest wielkie święto.
It is a celebration. To be welcomed with such understanding, with the reception that I'm seeing here by the great Paris audience, and we appreciate that greatly.
La réception de la part du public est extrêmement importante et d'une grande qualité, et je vous en remercie pour cela.
Ale musimy zadać sobie pytanie, co dalej.
But we need to ask ourselves what next. Now that
when
a retrospective of work by this great Polish artist is being held, we need to ask ourselves what next and who will be next.
Que va-t-on devenir? Qu'est-ce qui va arriver par la suite?
Więc przechodząc już do meritum sprawy.
And moving on to the substance. And again, to quote the patron of our institution, the great Polish poet Adam Mickiewicz, I ask myself, dull and dark, and what comes next, what comes next? The times are indeed hard, and here I would like to ask the witches of Polish theater for their succor, young artists who might represent a slightly different approach, different aesthetics, and I'm sure it's worth listening to what they have to say. We have five artists, one of whom is not with us physically. We will be seeing a video recording.
Cinq metteurs en scène, cinq sorcières, dont une ne peut pas être présente, mais on a fait un enregistrement vidéo pour que vous puissiez l'entendre. Et je vais lire parce qu'en fait, j'ai noté, et comme Mickiewicz l'a fait dans Les Aïeux, j'invoque donc les sorcières, et je cite celui qui donne son nom à notre institut, le grand poète polonais qui écrivait en exil ici à Paris. Tout est obscurité à présent, tout est sourd. Que va-t-il devenir? Que va-t-il advenir? Parce que les temps en Pologne sont très difficiles en ce moment.
trudno jest na całym świecie i dlatego
but the times are hard around
chciałabym zadedykować ten wieczór pierwszemu prezydentowi niepodległej Polski, który właśnie 16 dnia został zastrzelony przez czarnego artystę.
Crazed artist
le temps sont très difficiles, pas seulement en Pologne. Je voudrais dédier cette rencontre aussi au premier président de la Pologne indépendante, qui était justement assassiné le 16 décembre par un artiste fou.
In a gallery, moreover, right?
Dans une galerie en Pologne.
Nie będę się broniła z nazwy ojcobójczynie, ponieważ
the
rozmowę będzie moderował autor tego powiedzenia, autor tej bardzo emblematycznej książki, Piotr Gruszczyński.
Tak, cette rencontre sera modérée par Piotr Gruszczyński, auteur du livre.
Piotr Gruszczyński jest the dramaturg of Nowy Teatr in Warsaw.
Donc de parricides, mais ici il s'agit des filles,
with Krzysztof Warlikowski.
Fatherkillers. Ou donc on peut dire des filles assassines, si on veut traduire, on veut pousser la traduction vers le français.
I w rozmowie uczestniczyć będzie osoba, której jestem bardzo wdzięczna. Wszyscy
also
jesteśmy bardzo wdzięczni za zorganizowanie tej konferencji,
debaty i koordynację wszystkiego, debate,
wymyślenie tej idei i moderację. Chcę bardzo serdecznie podziękować pani Sylwii Martin-Lamani.
Je voudrais surtout remercier Sylwii Martin-Lamani d'avoir coordonné cette rencontre, de l'avoir permis.
Ja dziękuję Państwu bardzo. Kończę przynudzać i chciałam zaprosić Państwa.
Thanks for your attention and let's begin with a brief video recording. A talk with Weronika Szczawińska, who could not make it to Paris today.
Pour ma part, c'est fini. Je vous invite à regarder la vidéo avec la metteuse en scène Weronika Szczawińska, qui ne pouvait pas être ici parmi nous ce soir.
I have the impression that our society has rarely undergone a crisis, actually is undergoing a crisis that women have seen already, have foreseen, but women are not seen as first-class or full-fledged citizens. I studied at the Warsaw Academy of Drama, and it was a strange moment in the life of the Academy when a lot of women were accepted into stage directing. My year, my class, and the class after me was full of women. Previously, classes were made up exclusively of men, or there was one woman, but now classes had 5-6 women, and men, boys were in the minority, which led to jokes. People started saying that being a stage director was no longer, didn't have the cachet it used to, since women are getting into it. But on the other hand, our teachers were very happy to see so many of us women. They were happy because they were surrounded, as they said, by beautiful ladies. We wanted to be treated seriously, since there were so many of us, and we didn't allow them to patronize us, but still they did treat us like little girls. They mansplained things. They said, oh, make babies or have babies as soon as possible, otherwise you'll go crazy eventually. And people said that this job, when done by a woman, needed a lot of qualifications and a lot of preconditions. But the situation was very comfortable, great, compared to the situation of artists, female artists, 10 years older than me. Because back then, the voices were very, it was very radical. They said a stage director is not allowed to get pregnant, or they would, or professors at Polish universities would welcome us, saying, hello, gentlemen, oh, I'm sorry, lady and gentleman, and they named the only woman in the department. So I was studying in a transition period when you saw signs of change and you saw how much the structure wasn't adapted to us. We were in the majority, but we were still treated like little girls. There were more of us, but we still encountered inappropriate comments regarding our work. When they were reviewing our work, there was always an attempt at patronizing or downplaying what we did, and there was a sense of being threatened. We felt we needed to be careful, tread cautiously, because we were women. You start working in small budgets, and you see that it is possible. My first piece had a budget so low that I won't even mention it, but everybody, I thought it was okay. This is my debut, it's my first piece, my first production. But then I realized that with the right approach, you can do something for a little money, but then the budgets go up, but you already know how to cut corners, how to save money, how to be frugal. So the first message, the first thing you're taught is that if you don't, you won't have hundreds of thousands, a six-figure or a seven-figure budget, but you can get everything done nonetheless. But then you start thinking how that's done. You get more money and you know what you need, and you also know what's superfluous, what's additional. There's a double game that begins here, because the awareness that you will do a piece for a small amount of money means that in theaters they won't grant you a larger budget or a larger fee. And this does translate into gender terms. It's a gender thing, but it's also hierarchical. Namely, are you running for the, do you want to be the best Polish director? Are you taking part in the hustings in the race? Do you want your name to be there, or do you want to do huge productions? That's not a dream of mine, because ideologically that runs counter to my theater, to my approach to theater. I mean, yes, I do money. I do need money, because everybody needs to make a living. Everybody wants to live decently. So I'm not in favor. I'm not an advocate of lowering prices. I'm not, or fees. Don't let anyone work for free who's on the team, no matter, I mean, I don't ask people, friends, to do me favors, just gratuitously or free of charge, but you also, I don't need to negotiate for a higher fee, because that translates into cutting the fee for people. I mean, there is some flexibility, but this applies to three or four people who can bump up their fees to a given degree, but and these are mainly men who can afford to do that. But since it is public money, if you take more, other people will get less, and that's also a message you send to the audience. Meaning, if you do something opulent, that's a world that we want to identify with. But I relate to the tradition of the avant-garde, where you test certain ideas, certain models, certain shapes, approaches, and for that you need a safe, good work. Working environment, but you don't need huge money to achieve that. My topics are things that revolve around community, around utopia. These are things, topics that relate to the possibility of refurbishing, maybe, or changing societies, groups, the community in which we live. That goes for the piece we're working on at the moment. This will be a piece about the Paris Commune as an event, as a myth, and as an event that's very powerfully linked to our everyday life, or the present day. It's not a historical piece about the Paris Commune, but it will address, look at visions of the Paris Commune. You have very contemporary things on division of labor, the role of artists, and we'll use that to talk about ourselves, to study, to explore things, questions of community, and that's a thing that we'll be working on. But the question of of community was also present in a piece we did 2 years ago in Teatr Stary in Krakow called The Genius and the Turtleneck, which applied to the myth of the great stage director Konrad Swinarski with his trademark turtleneck. But the question was, does a community need a master, need a bard, need a maestro, need a leader, need a virtuoso? So we sometimes called it several characters in search of a master, in search of a maestro, in search of an idol. So it wasn't a show about Swinarski, but it was, as a collaborator of mine says, it was about a keystone of community. And this keystone of community is something that we look at. We see if it's a keystone or if it's something that can be displaced, whereupon the community assumes a slightly different shape. I'm always reluctant to see theater as entertainment. I like shows that are funny. I try to have an element of humor in my work, but ideologically speaking, or as in, if I were to produce an ideological statement, theater has to pick at the scabs, if you will, needs to address difficult topics, and it's a place of difficult radical choices. So if I were to answer personally, what matters to me, I see two models of theater, one which in an open way addresses social topics, issues of community, things that are engaged and involved politically, and the other extreme is a theater that's radically intimate, because all in all, it's the same at the end of the day. If you look at something in a very radical way, it is an experience of community to some extent. So if you look at Michał Borczuk, a Polish young stage director, who manages to reject, to deny the need for a critical opposition, but he does somehow, using his own very private perspective, be critical. Entertainment, variety, and so on. I use all the means of expression because it's all around us. It's there. Actually, no, entertainment is all around us in the in cinema, online, in video games, on TV. If anybody watches TV anymore, it's in TV series, which can be light and entertaining. But so I think that an institution where you have a direct contact with the audience, publicly funded, shouldn't really bother with entertainment too much and be too focused on entertainment. But we also need to be mindful of the context where what we do, the context in which we're working, because we're not pioneers, we're not landing on stage in a UFO and a flying saucer, and we find a perfect environment when we can thrive, flourish. We need a point of transition, we need a moment where audiences, viewers need to be nurtured and need to be taught a way of seeing things. So you need shades of gray. But I'm thinking of a theater that continuously, again, picks at scabs if the image is to be sustained. That stirs things up. I'll have to speak, I'll be speaking loud because we only have one microphone and we want the interpreter to use it. I'd like to invite our guests. On the left is Magdalena Szpecht. Katarzyna Kalwat,
Anna
Smolar,
Anna Karasińska.
And Anna Karasińska. During this talk, we'll be showing stills from pieces by our by the stage directors. And I hope that their shows will be brought to Paris soon as well. But before we begin, trying to say which fathers were killed,
wytłumaczyć też Państwu związek tego spotkania z tematem przewodnim z
jednego
z ustawicznych.
First, I want to ask Sylvie to make the association between this meeting and the overriding topic of the Paris Autumn. The overarching. Okay, I'll also try and speak loud and clear. I'm the co-director of this event, and last year we published an issue of this periodical called Women's Stages. It has a subtitle, and it addresses a topic that we were interested in, the position of women in theater, the position of women in theater generally, in France and Belgium, because we are French and Belgium periodical, and we let women artists, female artists from all over the world speak about their artistic practice, trying to determine whether there was a feminine way of making art or not, which is, some people found it a stupid question, others didn't. We had a whole range, a whole gamut of women from feminists who were very... There are studies that have been made in France. And it is to be hoped that everybody understands French. Now there's a little bit of commotion occasioned by the fact that the foregoing needs to be translated into Polish for the benefit of Polish audiences listening at home. Anyway, in France, there are studies conducted by the Ministry of Culture and various institutions regarding theater, and we realized that women make up less than 30% of the profession.
So they're
at the edge of visibility, if you will.
I okazało się, że kobiety zajmują są pod 30% tylko miejsce, 30, że zajmują 30%. Czyli są bardzo mało widoczne.
So women are underrepresented.
À partir de ce constat affligeant, on a donné la parole à des metteuses en scène.
Consequently,
à des auteurs
we decided to let female stage
directors, a female authors, dans nos éditions. Pour systématiquement mettre au féminin les noms qui devaient l'être. Et j'avais envie de, d'interroger
ces artistes we have here today. I wanted to ask them what their thoughts are regarding the position, the place of women, women artists in Polish society today.
Czy to, co się w Polsce dzieje, jeśli chodzi o sytuację Polek w Polsce, na przykład zakaz aborcji?
This is a question not about the situation, actually. Does the current situation of women in Poland today, for example, having to do with the ban or attempts to step up the ban on abortion, does that affect your work? I think it affects our work in that it distracts us from doing what we'd like to do instead. We need to revisit second wave feminism. I feel that there is some sort of coercion against female artists in theater, addressing issues of women and controversial matters, matters which are seen as controversial in public debate. So there is pressure exerted on women not to do that. There is, of course, I mean, I can speaking for myself, there is a need to perceive women in theater differently, to find another way of seeing women in theater.
Nie z punktu widzenia, tak jak to było do tej pory, zdeprecjonowanego, potraktowanego instrumentalnie ciała, ale z punktu widzenia odbicia jako inny w teatrze. Dwa punkty, by parler du corps dépréciés de la femme, mais d'un regard différent de la femme au théâtre.
Mój
najbliższy spektakl będzie dotyczył kobiet, które są dziewczynkami współczesności. Mon prochain spektakl va concerner les femmes qui sont des icônes contemporaines. Ale mój ostatni spektakl opowiadał o mężczyźnie, o kompozytorze, zapomniany Tomaszu Korcu. Mój moderny spektakl parle d'un compositeur polonais oublié.
And I don't want to feel forced into taking up issues of femininity in theater.
But
what I'm personally most interested in is the tension. Between my life, my professional life, my desire for autonomy, and my private life, because I'm a mother and I as well, and I think this is an issue that's a taboo in theater, that continues to be taboo in theater. I feel that nobody thinks about, gives any thought to women who are artists and mothers at the same time.
I think that
there are pieces about maternity that seek to break, abolish the taboo about being a woman in Poland. So I see it a little bit differently. There are books being written. There's a Turkish female woman writer who wrote a book about postpartal depression and issues of transformation and a scattered identity, dispersed identity, which is what happens when a woman becomes a mother. And there was a lot about being an artist, being a mother, and being a woman.
Une réflexion en fait sur le fait d'être femme et mère.
And in Poland, there's a very interesting book published recently on the same subject or similar subject by someone called Natalia Fiedorczuk. Getting back to whether it's comfortable, it's easy to work in Poland or not, whether we feel comfortable working in Poland.
I felt something very positive
after the last events having to do with the anti-abortion bill.
Ce droit à l'abortion est sorti, en fait. L'interdiction de l'avortement, oui, pardon.
Because on October 3rd, they called a strike for all women and men in Poland.
La journée totale de la journée de grève générale.
The general strike. Civic strike, and very, very many women went out into the streets.
Ça concernait pas juste des petits groupes. mais vraiment d'une façon très large.
These were in small groups of protesters, but it was a mass, a movement, and some sort of creative energy,
an infectious energy emerged. Extrêmement positive quelque part.
I
agree, I think good things are happening.
So maybe the traumatic
restrictions, the traumatic circumstances and the restrictions they're trying to thrust upon us actually end up extending the scope of liberty, furthering freedom.
Dobrze, to krótki, jeszcze jeden krótki wstęp.
And another brief introduction.
Bo kiedy w latach 90s, określiłem grupę wstępnych do teatru reżyserów,
stage directors as patricides.
In the title of my book, or Fatherkillers,
if you prefer. There was one woman among them, and I was accused, first of all, by those whom I failed to mention, that I didn't mention them, of neglecting them, and second, I was accused by those I described, that who said that they had nothing in common, and they really shouldn't have been thrown into the same bag, and I think we're dealing with a similar situation here. We don't want to prove that there's a group of women working together doing something in common. That's not the point. No, that's not what this is about. It's not a
group
of like-minded women.
A jednak ten fenomen, że pojawiło się tak dużo zdolnych,
whereby so many young, talented female directors have emerged, and Johan Klaus identified them or is looking closely at them, and this led me to consider whether there might be certain things in common that they have. I think their first shared feature, all five of them share.
Jest sposób, w jaki traktują teatr jako dyscyplinę kompletnie niezależną od literatury, a nawet literatury teatralnej.
No, comment elle traite le théâtre d'une façon comme une discipline indépendante?
Literature pour le théâtre. Ale także traktują go niezależnie od wszelkich konwencji czy norm, czy tego, czego uczyliśmy się, do czego
dawno. Są standards, any received wisdom as to the purpose of theater.
Natomiast wydaje mi się, że pozostają wierne takiemu przekonaniu, które
Polscy
teatrowcy
mają
bardzo dawno.
Ale my
jesteśmy encore aujourd'hui au théâtre en Pologne.
Że to właśnie teatr, a nie życie, może być miejscem, w którym odkryjemy prawdę.
Not life is the place, the locus where you can find the truth.
Co wydaje mi się szczególnie ciekawe i istotne, to będzie tak dużo mówić o czasach postprawdy, w których żyjemy.
To jest ekstremo
postprawdy.
Dans les temps de post-vérité.
I myślę, że mamy kolejny raz do czynienia z takim działaniem, tak jak się w pokerze w kartach mówimy, sprawdza.
I'm in poker, where you check, you call somebody's bluff, and that's what theater is doing.
I druga rzecz, o której też trochę była mowa, mówiła Weronika Szczawińska, nie wiem, ile to wynika z partly,
I don't know to what extent it relates to the gender of the artists.
Si c'est lié au fait qu'elle soit femme.
Ale rzeczywiście one pracują inaczej, pracują bardzo kolektywnie.
But it's true to say that they do work a little differently. They tend to work more collectively. And in a way, they overthrow, they subvert the position of omniscient stage directors and the all-powerful, almighty stage directors. There were female stage directors in Polish theater previously.
Ale należąc do wcześniejszego pokolenia,
but as members of, as representatives of an earlier generation, they sought to supplant, to step into the shoes of the omnipotent director.
And the omniscient director.
And one last common trait
is that
they place their trust in small-scale forms, because the small-scale forms are more interactive by definition, by nature, and can evolve, the audience can engage audiences better. And now a fundamental question regarding patricide.
Ponieważ to spotkanie odbywa się również przy okazji portretu Krystiana Lupy.
Held in some conjunction with the portrait of Krystian Lupa.
I w mojej książce z lat 90. Lupę określiłem jako ojca założyciela polskiego.
I referred to Lupa as the founding father of new Polish theater.
Że nommé Krystian Lupa comme père założyciela teatru polskiego. Le fondateur du théâtre polonais.
Le nouveau théâtre.
Du nouveau théâtre polonais.
W związku z tym mam pytanie, kogo wy tak naprawdę zabijacie?
Who are you trying to kill? Is that Lupa? Two of you have worked with him, have been his assistant.
Est-ce Lupa? Donc deux parmi vous ont travaillé avec lui.
Czy to jest reżyser wszechmocny,
the omniscient and omnipotent stage director as a figure?
Pouvoir total.
Z kim walczycie?
So avec qui who are bataille? You fighting against?
Kiedy pojawiło się to określenie w naszego spotkania i naszej rozmowy, zastanawiałam się,
that this talk would be called patricide, I started wondering whether it was a patricide or more of a relay race, where you hand the other athlete the baton,
je me demandais si en effet il s'agissait de cela, ou alors plutôt quand on passe une course dans l'athlétisme et on passe le relais, voilà.
And I think that in art, as in all other areas, if you want to move something forward, you need systematically to take down new paths, new tracks, new things that haven't been done before, or maybe transform process things that have been done, looking for an element of novelty. And you can't repeat things that have been done before, but this has nothing to do with killing anyone. Of course, it's much easier to define yourself
when you
are in a position.
Il s'agit pas forcément de tuer, mais de chercher à avancer, de en fait de dévier les voies.
To znaczy, mówię chyba o tym, że
I think
ucząc się, studiując reżyserię,
studying stage directing,
w takim tradycyjnym polskim modelu,
the traditional Polish model, the traditional Polish curriculum,
to zaczęłam robić potem, zaczęłam robić wbrew swojemu kształceniu, wbrew temu, czego mnie nauczono w szkole.
Later, having done that, later I realized that everything I was doing professionally went against the grain of everything I'd been taught.
Więc po prostu jest dobrze być w jakiejś opozycji, ale jednocześnie rozumieć, że ta opozycja jest obowiązkową kontynuacją.
C'est bien d'être en opposition, mais en sachant que cette opposition
est une sorte de continuation.
is a form of continuation,
and that's actually not a threat.
It doesn't threaten art, it only revives it.
I mean,
people are saying that if we do shows collectively with no script, we'll bring down the walls of traditional theater, we'll undermine the heritage.
To zupełnie nieprawda, bo zawsze będzie dużo ludzi, którzy robią taki teatr, dlatego że oni go robią, my nie musimy go robić.
Traditional theater, and thanks to them, we don't have to.
My nie musimy, tak.
So we have no obligation to do traditional theater.
Ja myślę, że jeżeli kogoś zabijam,
to myślę, że I think it's myself I'm killing each time around. I think this kind of struggle that I engage in whenever I approach a topic, subject, this need to open new doors each time around, and to start from scratch, that's the most difficult thing. I wish I didn't have to bear this responsibility, didn't have to shoulder this responsibility. I wish I didn't have to censor myself.
To znaczy zwolnić się z takiej konieczności ciągłego pokazywania siebie i ciągłego rozwoju. To znaczy stworzyć sobie jakąś taką przestrzeń totalnej wolności. To znaczy
powiedzieć sławie, nic nie muszę. Total freedom, where I'm not bound, obliged to do anything, where I'm not bound to start over, fail again, fail better. When I was Krystian Lupa's assistant, I worked on two of his projects, Persona Marilyn and Persona Body Simone, it's about Simone Weil.
I learned that
Krystian taught me
właśnie takiej wolności i jednak takiego przekonania, że podczas drogi, którą podejmuje, trzeba sobie stworzyć przestrzeń na popełnianie
błędów.
Lorsqu'on avance, il faut pouvoir se créer cet espace où on peut faire des erreurs, en fait. On peut se planter.
Allow for mistakes, because otherwise that's the only way this road can lead to anything creative or be creative as a process. I don't want to kill anyone. I have also have a sense that
robienie teatru teraz w Polsce jest bardzo ekscytujące, dlatego że
jest exciting today, because we do have masters.
Ale jest też bardzo dużo inspirujących osób w różnych dziedzinach
sztuki,
i mamy też dużo różnych osób, które jakby pokoleniowo są tak pomiędzy, albo też bardzo cenne jest to w polskim artystycznym środowisku, że jest mniej hierarchiczna,
namely, that it's less hierarchical than it would be, say,
mniej zamknięte, jest większy przepływ takiego dialogu,
the dialogue is more fluid, is easier.
Więc właściwie wydaje mi się, że żadna z nas chyba za bardzo, znaczy ja w każdym razie się nie mierzę z tą kwestią jakiegoś spadku nie ma czegoś takiego jak jakiś paraliż związany z ciągłością, z
przekazem.
Myślę, że żyjemy w czasach, kiedy w sztuce dosyć oczywiste jest to poszukiwanie własnego głosu, jednocześnie nie będąc odcinkiem tego, co się dzieje wokół.
A voice of their own, of course, without being oblivious to what's going on around them.
Et où c'est possible.
Oui.
Ja, ponieważ mówię jako ostatnia, to mam taką refleksję na to ogólne dotyczącej wszystkiego, co mam dzisiaj powiedzieć. Ja bym powiedziała, że ja widzę jednak jakiś rodzaj niebezpieczeństwa generowanego przez to, co możemy uznać za wspólne dla nas wszystkich. I to jest takie niebezpieczeństwo dla tego teatru, który nazywa tutaj, na użytek tej rozmowy, monumentalnym. Ponieważ mam nadzieję, że udaje się w tych spektaklach, które tutaj widziałam moich koleżanek, powiedzieć równie ważne rzeczy w sposób równie istotny i mieć jakiś wpływ na rzeczywistość istotny, jednak schodząc z tego, o czym mówiła Weronika, to znaczy zarówno z tej formuły bycia wszechwiedzącym reżyserem, jak i wielkiego budżetu. Czyli gdzieś rozwijamy to połączenie pomiędzy tym, co monumentalne, uznane, opisane i oparte na dziełach literatury. To połączenie między tymi ważnymi, ważną literaturą i monumentalizmem zostaje rozbite i wydaje mi się, że to jest pewnym zagrożeniem, dlatego że może się okazać, że ta świadomość, że nie tylko tak można mówić różne rzeczy, no zmieni też spojrzenie na te monumentalne dzieła.
Dobrze, czyli jedna osoba się przyznała do
do
winy. Ja myślę, że oczywiście to rozmawianie o ojcobójstwie czy nie ojcobójstwie jest może trochę zabawne, maybe a little do końca coy, maybe do rzeczy. Bo
wtedy parler du Paris preposterous in some way, son père, enfin ses pères, peut-être quelque part amusant.
Ale wydaje mi się, że tak, że wracając jeszcze na sekundę do Krystiana Lupy, że też macie to szczęście, że udało się wytworzyć w teatrach repertuarowych w Polsce, na szczęście nie we wszystkich, jak powiedziałem, że te teatry repertuarowe tworzą wam przestrzeń do działania.
Że te teatry repertuarowe
i to jest rzecz dosyć nowa, bo jednak bardzo długo teatr repertuarowy działał tak, że realizował teksty z kolejnego stage, to było jego główne
zadanie. Their purpose was to put texts on stage, dramatic texts.
I mam do was pytanie bardzo poważne.
The very serious question that I'd like to ask you.
Pytanie właśnie o tekst w teatrze.
About text in theater.
Je vais vous interroger sur le texte au théâtre.
We France, wszyscy słyszeliśmy o śmierci autora.
We all heard about the death of the author.
Et en France, on a tous entendu parler de la mort de l'auteur.
Wydaje mi się, że w waszym wypadku nie ma prochów po prostu.
That in your case, in your work, the ashes have been scattered.
I chciałbym, żebyście powiedziały, dlaczego tak naprawdę nie macie zaufania do tekstu,
bo nie macie.
Dlaczego wolicie tworzyć własne scenariusze
same
bo bo to wydaje się dla was charakterystyczne, że tak naprawdę czyli wasze działania bardzo
autorskimi. Puisque ça semble très
caractéristique en ce qui vous concerne.
I czy po nocach nie marzycie o tym, żeby wystawić Hamleta?
And do you ever dream of staging Hamlet when nobody's watching? I mean, do you ever catch yourself? I do dream of staging Hamlet. I do. I feel that I only now do I understand the Hamlet. I'd like to do it.
Bo oszczędziłabym sobie całego trudu przeprowadzania procesu bez tekstu.
To jest zupełnie ten proces, który wiąże, żeby arriver au texte, en fait.
It's a question of approaching the text, that's the process is unpredictable, but I launch into the process of working without text for a number of reasons, no matter how unpredictable and fraught it can be, but that's because I believe that working with a text won't lead you where work with process does, because a text is the product of a process that somebody's already gone through,
somebody else's process.
No i po prostu umieszczam się w tym procesie i pozwalam, żeby przemówiła przeze mnie wyższa siła.
Begin the process and let some higher force speak through me, or let some higher force speak. And when you have a text, you're in the comfortable, convenient position, that's something
is almost defined. Ale niekoniecznie musi to być czymś, co będzie tak mocno oddziaływało jak właśnie
formed,
procesu.
But you can never be sure that it'll affect people as much as the outcome of this process that you enter into.
I jest to też wynikiem mojego zainteresowania teatrem, które jest specyficzne.
That has to do with my interest in theater.
Ponieważ nie bardzo interesuję się teatrem, który jest do oglądania w takim sensie, że to, co się wydarza, może się wydarzyć bez aktywnego udziału publiczności,
can happen without active audience participation,
energetycznego udziału.
At least in terms of an energetic component, the energy feedback.
The rapport. La participation, merci, la participation active du public.
I started working in theater because I'm interested in the reality of the encounter.
We're meeting here today, we are present truly. The process where a text is generated is very time consuming, very arduous. My second to last project, Holzwege, took a year to germinate, to develop.
Moje projekty powstają w trzech etapach.
Mathematical framework or some sort of rhythm for the text.
I trzeci etap odbywa się najczęściej kilka miesięcy później, to jest w międzyczasie cały czas pracujemy nad tym tekstem, ale nawet wtedy, kiedy zaczynamy, on wciąż nie jest gotowy. Zaczynamy trzeci etap próby. Dlatego, że to, co wtedy jest najbardziej fascynujące, to tworzenie tego świata i tego tekstu w oparciu o osobowości aktorów.
Based on the personalities of the actors, the individuality of the actors.
Tous en parlant, fait des personnalités de chaque comédien. I improwizacji, które są które dają często start nowym scenom, całym scenom, które są
lead to new scenes which are written by the dramaturg in rehearsal.
Najczęściej coraz rzadziej jest tak w polskim teatrze, że jak się przychodzi na pierwszą próbę i ma się kilka stron tekstów, to aktorów ogarnia przerażenie. Chciałam powiedzieć, że jest coraz rzadziej jest tak, że aktorzy ogarnia przerażenie na widok
prawy tekst.
Trzy, cztery lata temu, kiedy
projekt.
Actors asked me,
what do I have to offer? Actors wanted to know what I have to give them on day one.
And for me,
I want actors to contribute to the creation of this world.
I że komunikując się z widzem, mówię o swoich własnych doświadczeniach, konfrontacji z tym tematem,
speak of their own experience in the face or vis-a-vis a given topic.
Też gdzieś rozwijam się w tych swoich poszukiwaniach dramaturgicznych.
I'm continuing my dramaturgical explorations. The text is a space, a vehicle of exploration, to the extent that in one of my recent projects, together with my dramaturg Marta Sokołowska, we came up with a number of versions of the text.
Które aktorzy performują na oczach widza.
Which actors perform
as spectators
watch them. In fact, you never know which way a show will go a given night.
Moja droga do porzucenia tekstu,
I abandoned text,
miała dwa aspekty.
Because of
dlatego, że z jednej
two
strony,
reasons, I began staging texts, a lot of French texts, including the French classics.
Ale z drugiej strony czułam tak narastające
but I felt a growing sense,
że bardzo często siedząc na widowni jako widz,
this sense when watching productions.
Że ja coś udaję,
I felt that I was
udaje,
pretending,
udaje,
the people next to me were pretending, actors were pretending, making
I coraz
pretending,
and increasingly
I began seeing people from outside the theater world, theater scene, who kept telling me how they hated theater.
I zaczęłam się nad tym
and I started wondering, and that led me to connect that with my own feelings, my own.
And I began seeing that the problem had to do with my relationship with text,
or what we're trying to do with actors in rehearsal with the text.
Więc zaczęłam sobie pozwalać coraz
taking liberties, I started introducing more improv.
I pojawił się taki moment, kiedy procent improvisations
prenait l'improvisation prenait une grande part en fait dans le spectacle.
Aż w końcu doszłam do wniosku, że właściwie ciekawie jest, kiedy aktorzy stają się współautorami. I wtedy oczywiście spektakl staje się jakimś dziełem bardzo zależnym od tu i teraz.
Dependent on the here and now is inextricably bound to the here and now.
Czyli też od widza, który akurat also, do niego
also depends on the spectator who comes to the theater on a given day. It depends on the venue, on the time of day. So it's affected by all these factors. And this alters, transforms the text of a play. Besides, it's very difficult to do surtitles to these pieces.
Jak również robić zastępstwo za aktora.
And to have understudies, or to have somebody standing in for an actor, rather. It's different with me. I don't know how, and I don't like to work with a text, and I don't like working with texts, because I don't believe in language and speech as an instrument of communication.
But znaczy ono jest takie, że wystarcza, ale tylko do pewnego sufficient, poziomu.
But only up to a point. It does the job, but up to a point.
And whenever I tell actors something at rehearsal,
I start feeling stupid three sentences in. After the third sentence. Because it's never what I wanted to say.
Teatr jest fajny dlatego, że da się z nim korzystać z tych wszystkich rzeczy poza językiem, poza mową. Gdybym mogła na przykład to by napisała, ale to jest o tych rzeczach, o których się nie da.
So
albo powiedzieć po prostu.
Theater is about things that cannot be said using words or language, I would say.
Mais il y a d'autres éléments qui sont extrêmement importants au théâtre, qu'on peut exprimer.
And that's why in my pieces I try to strip down our language to a minimum, pare it down.
Dobrze, to tak? Skończyłaś?
Tak.
To teraz chciałbym poprosić każdą z was.
Now could each of you in turn
żebyście opowiedziały o tym, co tak naprawdę, jakie tematy was interesują, które tematy uważacie za ciekawe do poruszenia w teatrze. Może też przy okazji, wiążąc to z tym, co w najbliższym czasie planujecie
maybe in with a view to your upcoming projects.
To jest zawsze bardzo kłopotliwe pytanie.
That's always a difficult question. It's an awkward question and an awkward situation.
Właściwie mogłabym wyjść od poprzedniej odpowiedzi.
I could follow up on what I said previously about collective work. Working collectively.
Wydaje mi się, że tworzenie w teatrze poza przyjemnymi aspektami jest czymś bardzo trudnym.
Apart from the pleasant parts is very difficult.
Évidemment, il y a des aspects extrêmement agréables, mais en effet, c'est quand même un travail qui est difficile.
trzeba pracować z dużą grupą ludzi.
You need to work with a large group of people.
I myślę, że z tym już jest problem.
That in itself is a problem.
I w pewnym sensie chyba w momencie, kiedy zaczynam przeżywać jakieś tam traumy związane z tym,
when I begin experiencing, when I begin feeling traumatized by that, which happens occasionally, I started looking at the relation between the individual and the collective.
And in my
our pieces, since we have a group of actors,
thanks to that,
we're able to address the issues of. We looked at groups, so first we dealt with a group of Jewish actors. Then we looked at students in school, we looked at the patients undergoing therapy, and I'm interested in observing and seeing what happens when a group begins revealing things or tries to conceal something. I think what's most important to me now is looking for truth, using the vehicle of theater, which is a fiction. In my most recent pieces, the starting point is always documentary, is always nonfiction.
And
based on this evidence, this body of evidence that we assemble together with actors, I mean, we're all investigators into the process. So based on that, we reenact the event on stage, or as for the benefit of spectators. But the truth of the event, the truth of the matter, cannot be determined because everybody has their own take on the situation. And this continuous search for truth, which increases the distance between ourselves and the truth, is similar to what we're dealing with in real life, when the copy is increasingly detached from the original. It peels away from the original, and reality becomes a simulacrum. So I think that what interests me in theater is to create a space where spectators could, via theater, become alert, vigilant, and know how to tell, how to distinguish between various types of truth. Briefly, I'm interested in the relation and people's relation with the world of nature and the image of the outside world, the natural world,
for
I started a wonder, and I was wondering for a long time, how come nobody does nature documentaries in theater, and that's what I'll be doing. Next.
I think I'm,
I never think of a subject, I don't define a subject at the outset, instead I try and think of the situation I want to stage manage, I want to create what will happen to the people I invite to take part in the situation.
I'm wondering, I'm trying to figure out what kind of situation it is,
where I am, who I'm dealing with, and what elements make it all up, how it's going to work. I try and figure out what experience can be achieved, what experience I'd like to evoke. I try and project that. And the subject is actually a pretext at the end. It's just an excuse to pretext. Briefly, I'd like us to talk about something Weronika Szczewińska made explicit, mentioned the economics of theater, the economics of means of production. And about democracy in theater. Because in Poland, we're living through a grave crisis of democracy as a political system. But and we're also used to people saying how theater is not democratic by definition, is not a democratic institution. At best, received wisdom is that talent is not distributed democratically, but also I want to ask about working methods, to what extent is partnership relevant, this exchange with others, or are there moments when you put your foot down and you say, I'm running this show, the book stops here? Personally, I find the principle very important,
because
in most theaters or based, democracy is not something that people, democracy and partnership is rarely seen in, or was rarely seen in the experience of my older colleagues. In my shows, no one's ever forced to do anything. That's a key principle.
I budowanie przekonania, czy utwierdzanie się w tym, że wszyscy jesteśmy artystami w tym samym miejscu, którzy współpracują ze sobą, jest dla mnie
to that we're all artists who have come together to work on something. We are all artists, so that's the... That matters even more than the outcome to me. And it also has to do with the thing that I'm still learning, so I don't know anything, and from actors are more experienced or older than I am, and I learn so much from them, and in a way, I don't feel authorized, I don't feel like to tell them what to do in a way or two.
Être sur mes acquis.
I mean, it's not because I feel inferior in any way, of course. I want everyone working with me to have to enjoy a lot of freedom, or as much freedom as possible. So you never banged your fist on the table, you never put your foot down. You know, I break out laughing rather than imposing my will, because theater is not a serious thing after all. And a community is a value.
Podchodzę do tego. Gdzieś dla mnie bardzo ważne jest to, że wszystkie elementy składowe mojego spektaklu
It's what's important for me is that all the components of my shows, my pieces have equal status. Sound, music, text, directing. I see them as having equal status, as equivalent.
Natomiast moim problemem jest to, że
Is that when I fall in love with an idea, I do my utmost to carry it out. So I stick with it. I agree with what, I relate to what Magda said. I'm increasingly more interested in how we work.
And if
theater is to be a place of utopia, the question is what relations obtain between people.
A właściwie kim w tym teatrze jest aktor?
Actually, it also has to do with who actors are in the theater, what is their social status. So I like it when actors start talking under their own name.
When they take
responsibility for what they say, what they do, for words and gestures and deeds. But I mean, I think it's not bad. The working conditions for stage directors in Poland at the moment are not bad. But I wonder, what I'm less sure about is the status of cultural institutions, even ones that profess very democratic ideals, but in their own operations, they're essentially oppressive. And I think that's a challenge for stage, for all of us, for stage directors. No, I put my foot down, I slam my fist onto the table. But that's because I feel I'm responsible for the process. Not the outcome, but the process.
And
I'm the one who needs to generate the energy needed to make it happen, and it has to be difficult, because otherwise it's not worth the while, it's not worth it. If it is to be worthwhile, it has to be difficult. So that's why you need someone who
takes
the burden upon themselves, because
konfliktowe, że się coś przełamuje, że jest acknowledge that the conflict is inherent, that you need to
overcome your limitations and whatnot, you won't get far.
Dlatego biorę tą odpowiedzialność na siebie, that's the responsibility that I assume.
I'm the person who started the
who stirred things up.
I'm the who stirred things up in the first place. And as such, I'm responsible for what. It's my job to make sure that everybody profits as much as they can from this work. But I don't believe that profit is attainable if things come too easily.
Proszę Państwa, jest 18, tam widzę, że niektórzy już spakowali walizki i wychodzą.
It's 6 p.m., but I see people are, some people are filing out, actually. Some people have planes to catch, including the Polish IT technician who partly who made some of this possible, and he is now leaving us. Now, do you have any questions you'd like to ask our...
J'ai juste une question parce que bon, je suis très intéressé par ce que vous avez dit, et notamment ce qui a été dit sur le texte. Et moi, je poserai une autre question qui n'est pas sur le texte, mais sur l'auteur.
Unfortunately, the question is practically inaudible, and it's being translated silently into Polish for the benefit of the stage directors. So it remains to be hoped that some idea of the question will come out in the answers. I write on my own, and that's the way I want it to be. But your, do you write productions, do you write not texts, not plays, but do you come up with texts? Do you define yourselves in such a way? Perhaps the it's about the visor. The only author whom I staged, the only play that I can read from start to finish, which I truly... Joël Pomera is the only playwright whose pieces I can read from through and through, so I never mess with him. I'll be staging Cinderella in Starry Theatre in Krakow. I work with a dramaturg whose name is, to answer your question, I work with a dramaturg called Michał Buszewicz on Jewish actors. That's my piece. Jewish actors, and we also have plans for the future. I think he's a very talented writer. And I think that after my, after what I experienced on my, separately on my own, we will start devising together again.
mais qui seront au cœur d'un scénario très mobile, très...
And it seems that we will,
get back to writing, devising chunks of text that will be important parts of the production.
Parce qu'on a eu beaucoup ça dans le passé. On a aussi des grands auteurs de théâtre qui ont commencé comme ça.
Some of you began by staging the
theater greats.
Or some of you also used feminist literature, like Sixu, I think.
Again. Czyli, że mamy do czynienia z sytuacją, kiedy reżyser staje się tak naprawdę autorem tekstu.
So effectively, directors become authors, and this is something we're seeing in France. But I think it's a little different. Owing to the significance, the import of the text.
Ponieważ to jest tekst, który nie daje wyjściowej struktury dla spektaklu, który jest jednym z jego elementów tak samo ważnych jak na przykład sytuacja albo ruch.
And this opening situation, this starting point can be equally important as a movement or a question or situations. Do we have any other? Who's your favorite playwright? Classical or contemporary?
My name is Shakespeare.
Shakespeare? Kto? I need a moment to think. Do you want? You mean a playwright, somebody who writes for theater? No, just a writer, a favorite writer, somebody who led you. I want to say Cortes, Bernard Marie Cortes.
And
Abe Kobo is an author I'm very much into now. I want to stage the woman in the dunes. Mainly because it's so atheatrical. It's an attempt to say something that's very difficult to express in theater. Yes, there was a movie. Albert Camus. I wrote my MA thesis on Camus. You asked about authors who brought us to theater. It's not that Camus brought me or led me to theater.
J'aurais plutôt tendance à dire je ne sais pas et j'ai complètement perdu le sens de l'orientation ces dernières années.
But
w moim wypadku to byłby Albert Camus, jego książka Pierwszy człowiek.
And his book The First Man. I'm not sure he was the one who led me, but recently I think I'm a little lost, and I can't really define who my favorite author is. I don't have this compass.
So, do I need to be translated by someone?
Mogę.
it's more of an observation than a question.
Bardziej uwaga niż pytanie.
But what has emerged listening to all of you, and it's been very, very wonderful, is that you're not set up as a resistance against a father or a brother.
Przysłuchując się temu bardzo interesującemu spotkaniu, widać, że nie ustawiacie się w kontrze do ojca czy brata, czy w opozycji do ojca czy brata.
But I mean, thus far, you're emergent young artists who are also women.
Jak dotąd jesteście młodymi artystami, którzy przy okazji są kobietami, żeby oddać ten angielski stosunek do
bratu, rodzaju dramatycznego? The blockages that culture puts in front of women in all professions, I would venture to say.
W obliczu barier, na które napotykają kobiety w każdym zawodzie.
But a lot of you talk about, you know, having significant mentors like Lupa, or wanting to do Hamlet, or, you know, devised work that takes off from a novel by a male, and all of that seems perfectly normal to me. It doesn't seem anti-feminist, it may or may not be feminist. So it's the pitching of the subject of women, young women artists must be inherently against men.
Ale niektóre z was przyznają się do tego, że mają mistrzów, a że chcą wystawić Hamleta, że chcą pracować z książkami męskich autorów, co jest całkowicie naturalne. A kwestia bardziej wiąże się z takim postawieniem tematu, że młode artystki i artystki z konieczności muszą się ustawić właśnie przeciwko mężczyznom.
I mean, I just wanted to make an observation.
Pour les femmes. At least it should be for women, not against men.
Yes, exactly.
Albo powinny właśnie opowiadać się za kobietami, jeżeli już niekoniecznie mają być przeciwko mężczyznom.
I hate what I'm doing, which is I'm not asking a question, so that's all I'm asking.
Very briefly to respond to what you said, but this is not an answer, just a remark on what you said. Okay, to remark on your non-question. Personally, if I can confess something, whenever I encounter another person, their gender doesn't matter in the least.
Dlatego ten podział na kobiety so reżyserki i mężczyzn reżyserów to jest taki jakiś zewnętrzny rodzaj teatru poza
is,
teatrem.
Is, I think, a type of theater that's external to theater.
C'est une division pour...
To
taki zewnętrzny teatr poza teatrem.
Teatr de l'extérieur en dehors du théâtre.
I mean,
I know that I'm defined by virtue of my gender and my young age, but that's not something I want to concern myself with.
Okay, czy ktoś z Państwa chciałby jeszcze czegoś się dowiedzieć?
En français, en français, je pense que ça va être plus simple. Quelle a été, comment dire, comment vous situez par rapport à,
where do you
par rapport
sit?
À la charge quand même,
where do you place yourselves?
Anti-femme, je dirais, du gouvernement actuel à travers la loi.
What's your position on the anti-feminine policies of the present Polish government?
Général du gouvernement ne vous apparaît pas aussi comme une un peu comme comme une forme d'opposition à vos vies et à votre travail ou pas du tout? Est-ce que vous en êtes complètement libéré aussi?
Tu peux pytanie jest trochę o czym mówiliśmy na początku.
To
The lady came in late and was not aware that the subject she asked about was already covered at the beginning. And it had to do with the political situation, how it affects their work as artists. Do you think is it easier for you to work with other women? I don't mean actors, but generally people you work with. So do you seek out women to work with? Or is it just a matter of chance? Is it some sort of chemistry between you and your female collaborators? I mean, do you have people you work with on numerous occasions, recurringly, repeatedly? Something I really wanted to say all this time. I mean, of course, I mentioned the collaborators. We have the long-standing collaborators, I mean, gender doesn't matter, but now that women are in theater, we have something that actresses, not stars, but actresses in smaller Polish theaters are telling me. They're telling me
that we're giving them hope that women
will be given richer or deeper roles to play than they had hitherto previously.
Że aktorki, dla których do tej pory role polegały na tym, żeby towarzyszyć mężczyznom, pięknie wyglądać i było bardzo mało kobiecych, pełnych i głębokich teatrów.
Weren't given deep, full, rich roles. Their job was to offset a man, or just to...
Se limiter en fait juste à la compagnie, l'homme, d'être une jolie femme, une belle compagnie.
To be what, eye candy? And they're hoping that there will be more of a balance, or the problem will go away altogether.
Dla mnie to jest bardzo ważne, z kim pracuję.
Pour moi, c'est extrêmement important avec qui je travaille.
It depends on who I work with.
I want to give everybody as much freedom as possible. It's important for me who I work with, because if I want to give everybody freedom, I need to trust them. There needs to be trust. There is a chemical valence, chemical bonds between us that is necessary.
To po prostu bardzo skraca rozmowę.
And it makes things all that much easier.
I startuje się w innym punkcie.
And you can start further down the road.
Mogę powiedzieć, że teraz po kilku moich...
Now, after having...
Od jakiegoś czasu mam taką stałą ekipę.
For some time I have a permanent group of people who work with me.
Z którymi współtworzę spektakle,
avec qui je crée ensemble le spectacle.
Dla mnie, jeśli chodzi o wybór współpracowników, płeć nie ma zupełnie znaczenia.
When selecting collaborators, gender doesn't matter.
To jest faktycznie kwestia jakiejś wrażliwości, porozumienia.
It's a question of a sensibility, it's a question of an understanding between us.
But recently I'm happy
to be talking to other female directors. I'm happy, not unhappy, as again, it's an enriching dialogue. It's
for me,
and it seems authentic and very sincere.
I to jest chyba ciekawe.
And I think that's interesting, and it also tells you something, I guess.
Jak
w ogóle pracujemy i myślimy
about
o
how we work, how we think about theater.
I tutaj faktycznie czuję jakąś taką różnicę
so here I feel,
z kolegami reżyserami.
Coś chyba it's different from when I'm talking to my male director colleagues.
Ramy tego spotkania mówiące o kobietach w teatrze mają jednak pewien sens.
I agree that there is a point to talking about women in theater. It's a valid.
Oui, effectivement, j'ai le sentiment que ce titre, ce cadre qui a été créé à l'occasion de cette rencontre a un sens pour ce qui est de la
so there's. Because we do have a sense of community, where there is a rapport among us, between us. One last question from Joanna Klaas. Can we do something now that would be a symbolic reflection of your work? Let's forget about the split, the division into audience and speakers. Let's open the door, let's let some fresh air in. And let's thank one another informally, and also let's have a drink. The answer to the question is resounding. I also wanted to say that we'd never be here if it weren't for Joanna Klaas, and we appreciate it a lot. I wouldn't have come here if it weren't for Joanna Klaas.